डॉक्टर APJ अब्दुल कलाम टेक्निकल यूनिवर्सिटी, मैसिव ओपन ऑनलाइन कोर्सेस, आई एम देवराज तिवारी, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, IIMT कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, ग्रेटर नोएडा। टुडेज आई एम हियर टू डिलीवर द लेक्चर ऑन मैकेनिकल सिस्टम डिजाइन। सो थ्रू दिस लेक्चर वी विल बी एबल टू डिजाइन द सिस्टम। डिजाइन द सिस्टम मीन्स वी शुड बी एबल टू डिजाइन द कंपोनेंट एज वेल एज द डिजाइन ऑफ द सिस्टम। सो फर्स्टली वी शुड नो व्हाट इज द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन द डिजाइन एंड द सिस्टम डिजाइन। इन द डिजाइन ओनली वी विल कवर द कंपोनेंट, बट इन द सिस्टम डिजाइन वी विल कंसिडर द कंपोनेंट अलोंग विथ द सिस्टम। मीन्स वी विल कवर द मैकेनिकल कंपोनेंट और द कंपोनेंट अलोंग विथ द सिस्टम। सो फर्स्टली वी शुड नो व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन द सिस्टम डिजाइन एंड द कंकरेंट इंजीनियरिंग। सो इन दिस व्हाट इज फर्स्टली वी शुड नो द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सिस्टम, we should know the attributes of system, we should know the kinds of system. So firstly we are defining the system. A system is a collection of recognizable unit having relationship among the units aiming at specified single or multiple objectives, and it should be adaptable to the external environment. So accordingly, on the basis of definition of system, we have four attributes. These are assemblage, relationships, goal seeking, and the adaptability. Means firstly we should know the assemblage of the component, we should know the relationships of the component, we should know the what are objectives of the mechanical system design, and why our system should be adaptable to the environment. So these are the four attributes by which we have defined the system. So firstly, explaining the system design or the concurrent engineering, we should know how many types of system. So system may be classified as first as mechanistic or non-mechanistic. As example, guide missiles is the example of the mechanistic, and the production system where main consideration is to decision and the improvement. Always in the production system we are talking about the decision and the how can we improve the production system, always we are talking. Second, we can classify the system as open loop versus closed loop. Example of the open loop is as automatic traffic control. Automatic traffic control is the example of the open loop system, and the greatest example of the closed loop is to this traffic control by this manual. The manual traffic control is the example of the open closed loop, and the automatic traffic control is the example of the open loop. So the third we are considering here, the transparent and the non-transparent system. Means we are able to see the system. If the system is visible, then it is said to be transparent, otherwise it is said to be non-transparent system. So also the non-transparent system is said to be black box approach. So also we can take the example of non-transparent system. All the computer system is the example of the non-transparent system. So next, what is the system approach? Why we are using the system approach? So we are using the system approach for the organization and the society for this solution of the complex problems, for the optimization of the problems. So here, with the help of system approach, we can improve the problem, we can reduce the problems of the organization and the society. Also, we can solve the complex problems of the organization. And finally, on the basis of system approach, we should be able to optimize the system or optimize the component. So, next, how can we identify the engineering function? We can, these are the steps by which we can identify the system. Firstly, we will define the problem. This one is the first step by which, this one is the important step. Then we will form the model. There will be different types of model by which we can form. Then we will analyze and experiment the system. Then we will do the computation of the system. Then we will check the result, what is the result. If the result is ok, then we will optimize the system. After the optimization, the last step is to commercialization. If we are not able to commercialize the object, then there is no meaning of the system, because our objective is to, we should be able to convert our ideas into the commercialization. This one is the drawback of the our country, because we are not, mostly we are not able to convert our ideas into the commercialization or the business. Such as we have taken the example here, failure of high speed belt drive. Why the belt drive will be failure continuously, or belt drive is failure continuously? Because we are not taking all the factors which are considered in the belt drive. Because as belt drive equation, we should know, we know that T1 by T2 is equal to e to the power mu theta. Here we are not considering the centrifugal force. So, if we will not consider the centrifugal force, definitely the belt, there will be belt failure in the system. So, what we will do? Definitely we will consider the centrifugal force, means what the mathematical formulation of the belt equation will be? The mathematical formulation will be T1 minus centrifugal force, where T1 is the tensile force in the tight side, divided by T2 minus centrifugal force, T2 means in the tensile strength in the slack side, is equal to e to the power mu theta. Here, if you will consider this centrifugal force, then we can find out the problem of the failure of our belt drive. So, definitely, what is the concurrent engineering? It is recognized as a viable approach in which we will consider the simultaneous design of the products and its related process in a manufacturing system. We will consider the all the required matching of the products structural with function requirement and associated manufacturing implications. Definitely, we should know the conventional engineering, and we should know how can we improve the system with the help of concurrent engineering. So, in the conventional engineering, there will be this step. In the conventional engineering, all the process are in the series. Means, firstly, we will design the component, then we will manufacture the component. But in the process planning, we will do all the process, design process, manufacturing process in the parallel. So, we can improve the quality of the system. So, what is the concurrent engineering? What are the objectives of using the concurrent engineering? So, these are the objectives of using the concurrent engineering. We can decrease the product development time if we will use the concurrent engineering instead of conventional engineering. We can improve the profitability. We can have the greater competitiveness. We will have the better control on design and the manufacturing, because as I have said, we will do all the design, process planning and the manufacturing in the parallel. So, there will be better control on the design and the manufacturing. On the basis of concurrent engineering, we can improve the product quality, and also we can improve the product, promote the team spirit. So, what are the benefits or advantages of the concurrent engineering? This one is these are the results by which we are using the concurrent engineering. There is the improvement of 200 to 600% in the product quality. There is 100 to 200% higher customer satisfaction. There will be higher return on the investment. We can improve the return on the investment by 20 to 120%. We can reduce the time to the market by 20 to 90%. We can reduce the development cycle time of the component by 30 to 70%, and we can improve the sales. We can higher the sales by 5 to 50%. So, these are the benefits or advantages by why we are using the concurrent engineering. So, these are the results. We have taken these results from the different papers, different research papers. So, next, what are the weaknesses? These are the weaknesses, because if we have the insufficient product specifications, it will lead to an excessive amount of modification. So, definitely in the starting of the phase, we should consider all the constraint which we will take in this concurrent engineering. So, next is, what is the conclusion of the concurrent engineering? The conclusion is, why we are using the concurrent engineering? Conclusion is, time to market, our product will be available at the time to market, and we will, on the basis of life cycle, we can improve the quality of the component. So, these are the conclusion of concurrent engineering. Means, at the wherever the product will be required, the product will be available. Means, if we want to manufacture the air conditioning system, definitely it should be available in this summer. It should not be in the winter. So, definitely if we want to manufacture the air conditioning system, our air conditioning system should be available in this summer, not in the winter. So, and on the basis of life cycle means, if you will consider all the constant by which the life cycle of the component will be decided, such as manufacturability, testability, process planning, cost estimation, and so on, ergonomics, etc. If you will consider all the component, all these constant in the life cycle, definitely we will improve the life cycle of the component. Means, we will improve the reliability of the component, we will improve the testability of the component, manufacturability of the component, machinability of the component, and so on. So, on the basis of life cycle engineering, we will implies parallel consideration of product, function, design, material, production process, and cost with regard to later stage, such as testing, as I have said, service maintenance, operation, and further development. Means, we should be able to develop the system if we want to develop in the future. source. How can we define and solve the engineering problem? Firstly, we will consider the hierarchical system. Then, by the help of hierarchical system, it will describe how to develop an understanding of the general environment in which the problem occurs. This general environment reveals the systems that are involved and provides an overall view that may serve to guide the engineers. Next, we will find out the problem environment by which we will be able to define and solve the engineering problem. On the basis of problem environment, it provides the overall framework for attacking and solving the problems. And then on the basis of hierarchical system and the problem environment, we will go to the next level, and this goal is usually related to the objective of the next higher level system and next higher level system and so on. So, next we will make the problem statement of the system, then we will model of the system, we will make the model of the system. It will be, it may be different types of model, it may be descriptive models, it may be behavioral model, it may be decision model. So, what is the descriptive model? Descriptive model will show the relationship, order and the sequencing. Behavioral model will show the what is the social and the political aspect. And this, on this basis of decision model, we will be able to find out the most favorable solution among the alternatives. So, these are the three types of models by which we can find out the system, we can manufacture, we should be able to manufacture of the system. So, then we will make the need statement. What are the need statement? We know that need is the important thing by which we will fulfill our needs. So, these are the steps of the need statement by which we can identify and analyze the need. First, realization of the need. The greatest example of the realization of the need is the invention of bulb by Thomas Edison. So, with the help of realization, the beginning of any design process is recognition of need. The sources from which need perception results are as viewed as the need themselves. Here we have taken the example of bulb. This bulb was invented by the Thomas Edison. Thomas Edison was one such designer who went through great lengths in developing the electric lamp much before any significant segment of society desired it. Now, we can see the development of the system. Firstly, we are able to find out the bulb, then we are able to find out the LED bulb, and now we have this organic LED bulb. So, organic LED bulb is the next of this Thomas Edison invention. So, second, we will make the preliminary need statement. So, in all design situation, the first task of the designer is to determine what exactly is needed. For this, we have taken the Eskimo 9 dot problem. We will consider 9 dot and we will join all the 9 dot. On the basis of 9 dot, we can find out the problem of the system. Such as, if we want to protect the grains from the mice, then definitely we will use the ultrasonic sirens. On the basis of ultrasonic sirens, we can design the mice proof warehouses for grains. So, definitely ultrasonic sirens is this device by which we can protect the grains from mice. Next is analysis of need. How can we analyze the need? On the basis of normal distribution curve, we can analyze the need. Firstly, we can find out the specification, that is the standard deviation of the component, standard deviation of the system. Then we will check the performance parameters. This is said to be standard of performance, by which we will set of, it is set of complex requirements that cover a wide field of which may include such things as reliability, safety, convenience, adaptability, maintainability, and the cost, finally the cost. So on the basis of these factors, we can analyze the need. So finally, it should be cost. The people are able to pay the cost or not. On the basis of this, we should be able to design the system. Then we will check the environmental factor, means our component should be adaptable to the environment. So as we have say in the during the definition of the system, the adaptability to the environment is the important thing. What we have designed, it should be adaptable to the component. Means if we want to design the car which will be operable, which will operate in the minus 30 degrees Celsius, so it, if we will design the component which will, if we will design the car which will operate on minus 30 degrees Celsius, if we want to operate this car on plus 50 degrees Celsius, it will not work. So definitely we will consider what we will consider in the system design. And finally, we will check the resources. If the resources are available, then we will consider the system, we will manufacture the system, and we will adopt the system. Next, what are the roles of engineer if they are designing the system? As advisor or the consultant, engineers can play the important role. The engineers should be available to others for interpretation of data or views, etc. The next role of the engineers is as advocate or activist. Engineers can play the important role. It promotes the actively a process or approach. Next is, next work of the engineers or roles of engineers is as analyst. The engineers can play the important role. If the engineers are the analyst, he should be able to separate a whole into parts and examine them to explore also. Next, as boundary spanner, engineers can play the important role. They can bridge the information gap between engineering and user. As motivator, the engineers can play the important role. They can provide stimulus and skill availability to a group or an individual. As decision maker, the engineers can play the important role. The engineers select a preference from among many alternatives for topic of concerns. And among many alternatives, they should be able to find out the exact alternative. So, as designer or planner, the engineers can play the important role. Engineers produce the solution specifications and they can help to this system. As expert, engineers provide a high level of knowledge, skill, and experience on a specific topic. As coordinator and integrator, engineers can play the important role. As innovator, inventor, then engineers should know they seek to produce a creative or advanced technology solution. This would be able to measure the system. They obtain the data and facts about existing condition. As project manager, they can play the important role. They can operate, supervise and evaluate the projects by which we can improve the system. As trainer or the educator, they can improve the system by which in the skill and knowledge of concerned field of engineering, they will use the skills and the knowledge, and it should be benefit to the our society or as well as for the country. As trainer or the educator, the engineers can play the important role. As data gatherer, the engineers can play the important role. The last role of the engineers can play the important role as negotiator. So, on the basis of roles of engineers, we should be able to design of the system component. So why we have taken the consider the roles of engineers? So what will be the steps or cycles if we want to use this system engineering or the system studies? So these are the steps by which we can define this system engineering, and we should also be able to define the system studies. Firstly, we will define the objectives. It is the conceptual phase, which the objectives are classified and defined with a view to select a policy regarding action or decision making for solving the problem. So, firstly, definition is playing the important role in the system engineering and the system studies, if you want to system studies of the component or the system. Next, we should be promise for the alternatives. Second step means we promise alternative programs which can possibly achieve the objectives, or it may be thoughts or design. So, from the various alternatives, we should be find out the optimum alternatives, so best alternatives. Next, the next step is the model building. We will make the different models as I have studied in the next. On the basis of model building, what is this model building? We should be promise for the alternative programs, and it can be shaped into model. A model is an analog of reality. It represents the system qualitatively and quantitatively both. A model may be in physical form or in mathematical form or in behavioral form. As I have said, I have studied in the previous slide. Next step of the system study is to criterion. We will make the criterion. It is specified in effectiveness, cost performance, or cost against the performance. These are the criterion. Then we will make the preference of the alternatives, and we will select the best alternatives among the different alternatives. From the performance of model, various alternatives programs are tested in order to preference. Then we will verify the system component or the design component of the or the product. The most promising alternatives are tested by experiment, and their good points are verified. So these are the steps by which we will define the system engineering and the system studies. Next, what are the elements and techniques of the system analysis? If we don't know the elements and the techniques of the system analysis, we cannot design the system. So we should know. So we can, what we have said in the previous slides, we can make these slides in 3 points. Elements will be the objectives, the alternatives, and the cost. So what is the objectives? By the help of objective, we will discover what the objective of decision maker are of or should be trying to attain through the options open to him, and how to measure the extent to which they are attained. And the alternatives, measure by which it is hoped the objectives can be attained. And last is the cost, and this one is the very important. Costs are to be measured not merely in money, but also in terms of opportunity that they preclude. So definitely these are the elements by which we are able to design the system: objectives, alternatives, and the cost. What are the techniques in system analysis? Here it depends upon mathematical equation to exhibit the behavior of the system component, and the effect may exercise on one another. Some such techniques are, there are different techniques we can consider, but here in the next lecture we will consider the operation research, we will consider the CPM and the PERT, we will consider the simulation. With the help of operation research, we should be able to find out the best decision, and with the help of CPM and the PERT, we can find out what should be the path of the networking and what should be the duration of the path. And on the basis of CPM and PERT, we can also be able to allocate the resources, and also we will be able to allocation of the resources. With the help of this, we can crash the duration of the project also. This one is said to be crashing of the network. And last is simulation. Presently simulation is playing the important role in the decision making. So it is, what is the simulation? It is this experiment. If simulation is the process by which we can do the experiment on the computer. So in the next lecture we will consider these topics: operation research, CPM and the PERT, and simulation. So thank you so much.